think that it's not that we human beings have gotten better, but the environment.
I think that's exactly right. So we do legitimately say that that's, you know, Darwin's Rosalind Franklin was a genius, and those people on which the changes, pivots, those nodal events in the history of science or the history of the environment in which they're in is the stew from which they are allowed to emerge. I think there's a difference between the myth of the genius and the myth of the sort of heretical lone genius. Those two things are slightly different. I do think, for example, that Darwin had both the 99% grit facilitated by not having to work.
It helps.
It certainly does.
Dude, you gotta be freaking kidding me.
He carved out that theory over 20 years after being on the Beagle. So, that, you know, he didn't go to the Galapagos and see the forces. He went back home and spent years working on pigeon bones and writing to literally hundreds of people to ask for bits of information where he was carving out his argument. It was that intellectual environment enabled him to see further.
Right? Oh,
that's 1%, which one of the great scientists, to what I argue is the greatest scientist. And we mustn't forget that Alfred Wallace came up with exactly the same idea, in far less detail, at exactly the same time. He wrote to Darwin and said, "Here's
beautiful,
what
beautiful dude." What a beautiful man.
And in 1858, they announced it together.
Nice. So, holy shit.
Ill, and Wallace was out.